बढ़िया हुआ। मल्ली टू नो समथिंग सम principles established through will not do. Like I remember 10 dasmul of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, and I was giving class about 10 things, and it seems that I am in Madhyam Adhikari. I have prem because I'm giving class, I'm explaining to him also, Krishna is Akhil Rasam is Sindhu. I'm telling, as if I'm seeing in my hands this place. And after that, I will see that he has sank in the LED love, lust, in a moment. Those who are Madhyama Adhikari, they will not go down. Never. Never they will go down. They will take others, all Kanishtha Adhikari in Madhyam, but he will never fall down. These are symptoms. So that class of Madhyam Adhikari can take us to Madhyam Adhikari, and he can give seed of bhakti, and he can, by his Harikatha, he will develop our Krishna consciousness. I wanted to discuss something. Have you discussed something?
Yeah, we discuss everything.
In front of all, we should discuss, or alone we should discuss?
Maybe first alone and after. We can let everyone know.
But you can come to my room?
Yes.
But you should come and discuss something. How to preach? What about
Birmingham?
Birmingham. How to do
book publishing
here and there? Something. So you should wait. We should discuss something.
Oh, कृपा सिंधुभ्यैव च पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरतिशे नमः। गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै तदालयै कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो। मैं अपने परमाराध्यतम श्रील गुरुपाद पद्म नित्य लीला प्रविष्ट ओं विष्णुपाद श्री श्रीमद् भक्ति प्रज्ञान केशव गोस्वामी महाराज के चरणों में अपनी श्रद्धा प्रेम पुष्पांजलि उनके चरणों में अर्पित करता हूँ। I offer my whole honor, everything in the lotus feet of my Gurudev, Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnupad Sri Sant Bhakti Pragyan Kesava Goswami Maharaj. Yesterday, I spoke some English and very important thing for the devotees. Today I want to speak some general things for all, and I want to speak Hindi, and Navadvip Prabhu may translate in English because they requested me yesterday to speak in Hindi also. So I'm speaking in Hindi and he may translate. We should give some minutes for also others, so you should not be worried. I'm always giving. I don't know English, but yet in lame English, torn and worn English, I'm telling anything. But you are so kind to take the essence what I'm telling. आज मैं जो हिंदी जानने वाले हैं उनके लिए मैं थोड़ा सा कुछ बतला रहा। मैं नहीं जानता ये कितने लोग हिंदी समझेंगे। आई वॉन्ट टू दैट दे शुड रेज देयर हैंड्स दैट हु अंडरस्टैंड हिंदी। आप लोग हिंदी कितने आदमी समझेंगे? अच्छा ठीक है, थोड़े से हैं तभी हिंदी थोड़ा सा बोलूँगा। अच्छा एक राजा थे, बहुत ही विद्वान, अगाध धन उनके पास में था और खजाना भरा हुआ था, बहुत विद्वान थे। उनकी स्त्री बड़ी सुंदरी थी, उनका लड़का भी बहुत अच्छा था। There was a king. So learned, high learned. And he has so many appliances. He was so beautiful, young, energetic, wife so much beautiful and qualified. And he has also good son, very qualified son. एक दिन वो शिकार खेलने के लिए गया अपने राज्य में, और जब वो शिकार करते 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 दिन भर थक गया, उसको बड़ी जोर से प्यास लगी। प्यास लगने पर वो लौट रहा था, पानी ढूंढ रहा था, पानी नहीं मिला। तो एक आश्रम में गया वन के अंदर, जंगल के अंदर में एक ऋषि ध्यान लेकर के बैठे थे, भगवान का ध्यान कर रहे थे। ध्यान करते उनको होश नहीं रहा, जगत के सारी चीजों को भूल गए। दैट किंग वाज सो मच थर्स्टी, इट बिकेम इवनिंग एंड ही वाज सो थर्स्टी, सर्चिंग वाटर हियर एंड देयर, बट ही वाज सो थर्स्टी एंड देयर वाज नो वाटर अवेलेबल एनीवेयर। ही एंटर्ड इन ए वेरी डेंस फॉरेस्ट एंड देयर ही सॉ दैट देयर इज ए ऋषि महर्षि एंड ही इज मेडिटेटिंग सो डीपली। ही वाज माने उसके साथ में घोड़े थे, घोड़े पर चढ़ करके चलने वाला। ही वाज ही हैज हॉर्स राइडिंग ऑन दैट एंड सो मैनी फॉलोअर्स, उसके साथ में बहुत से सिपाही लोग भी और भी सोल्जर्स थे। और वो वन में गया, उसके घोड़े की टाप और उसके साथियों की बातचीत से ऋषि की का ध्यान भंग हो जाना चाहिए, किंतु भंग नहीं हुआ, भंग नहीं हुआ। जब भंग नहीं हुआ तो उन्होंने कहा, उनको प्रणाम किया, क्योंकि ऋषि लोग प्रणाम में होते हैं, और प्रणाम करने के बाद में पूछा जी महात्मा जी हमको पानी पिलाओ। तो सो मैनी हॉर्सेस विथ हिम, सो मैनी सोल्जर्स विथ हिम, सो द साउंड फ्रॉम द फीट फ्रॉम हॉर्सेस टप टप एंड ऑल वेयर टॉकिंग एंड प्रेइंग हिम दैट सेंड दैट यू शुड गिव मी सप्लाई मी सम वाटर, विदाउट आउट वाटर आई एम गोइंग टू डाई, सो जस्ट नाउ यू शुड गिव मी वाटर। बट ही वॉज नॉट हियरिंग एनीथिंग, वो कुछ नहीं सुन सका। साधु बड़े ध्यान में मग्न था, हमारे जैसा नहीं जो संध्या अनिक कर रहे हैं और मन इधर उधर जा रहा है, ऐसा नहीं। उनका मन भगवान में लग गया था टोटली, इसलिए नहीं समझ सके। जब नहीं सुना फिर उन्होंने तीन बार उनसे कहा, अरे महात्मा जी देख नहीं रहो जो मैं प्यासा हूं, किसका ध्यान लगा रहा है, तुम्हारे यहां पर आए पानी के लिए नहीं दे रहा है, तुम ध्यान लगा रहा है, मैं आपको खूब इनाम दे दूंगा, पुरस्कार करूंगा। तो अभी ऋषि का ध्यान नहीं छूटा। ही टोल्ड थ्री टाइम्स रिक्वेस्टेड फॉर वाटर लाउडली बट ही वॉज अब्सॉर्ब्ड इन मेडिटेटिंग, ही वॉज रियली मेडिटेटिंग, नॉट लाइक अस एट द टाइम ऑफ दीक्षा मंत्र, नॉट लाइक दैट। सो एट लास्ट ही टोल्ड थ्री टाइम्स एंड ही वॉज सो मच एब्जॉर्ब, जबकि वो तीन बार मांगने पर नहीं दिया, तो एक मरा हुआ सर्प लेकर उनके गले में लपट दिया। सब लपेटने के बाद में और चलने लगा। उसी समय में उसका लड़का कहीं पास में खेल रहा था। लड़के ने सुना किसी से, हमारे पिता के गले में एक आदि राजा आया और गले में सांप लपट करके चला गया, तो बड़ा क्रुद्ध हो गया। छोटा सा बच्चा, नंगा बट्टा, 5 वर्ष का ही उम्र था, बहुत क्रोधित होकर के पानी लिया और लेकर के आचमन करके पहले और पानी लेकर के छिड़क दिया, ऐसे यही सांप होकर के तुमको डांसे कटे काटेगा। हाँ, यू शुड टेल समथिंग व्हाट आई टोल्ड।
So Srila Gurudev already spoke a number of things in English. So just briefly summarizing, he was saying that one day this king, who was very wealthy, had good son, good wife, he went out to observe his kingdom, to oversee what was happening in the kingdom, and became thirsty, and became to this ashram of the sage who was absorbed in meditation, and he requested water from the sage, but the sage was so absorbed he didn't hear anything. So after requesting 3 times, and the sage just continued to be absorbed in his meditation, the king became angry, and he saw a dead snake on the ground, so he picked it up and garlanded the sage with the dead snake, and then left in anger. And the sage's son was playing nearby, and then he heard, received this news from someone, and he became very angry at the activities of the king. So then he took some water, he performed achman, and then threw that water and uttered a curse that the king would die from a snake bite.
After 7 days. सातवें दिन वो मरेगा, कोई रक्षा नहीं कर सकता. छोटा सा बालक, कितना ब्रह्म तेज. और हम लोग भजन का भजन करते हैं, कोई तेज नहीं. किसी को कह देंगे कुछ नहीं होता है. क्यों? वैसा यदि करेंगे तो हमें भी हो सकता है. राजा चलने लगा वहां से, सोचा यदि सचमुच में ये संत होंगे और भगवान का इन्होंने ध्यान किया होगा और मैंने गड़बड़ किया तो हमारा वंश जल करके खाक हो जाएगा और हम भी जल करके खाक हो जाएंगे. अब क्या करना चाहिए? और सोचते हुए जा रहा था, इतने में वो ऋषि का लड़का उनके पास में आकर के रो रो करके उनके उसमें गोदी में बैठ गया. उस समय उनका ध्यान जब भंग हुआ तो पूछा, जी क्यों रो रहा है? तो लड़के ने कहा, जी आपके गले में सर्प है, किसी ने डाल दिया और मैंने उसे अपशंपात करते, सातवें दिन सांप उसको काटेगा जरूर, कोई रक्षा नहीं करेगा. ऋषि ने देखा, जी तो परीक्षित महाराज थे, प्यास के वजह से या क्या जाने क्या बात, कोई है भगवान की इच्छा, बिना भगवान की इच्छा के ऐसा नहीं हो सकता है, इसलिए जरूर कुछ भगवान की प्रेरणा से ऐसा हुआ है. उन्होंने कहा, जब तुमको क्रोध नहीं होना चाहिए, तो तुम ब्रह्मचारी है, यदि क्रोध करेगा तो तुम्हारा सब ब्रह्मचर्य नष्ट हो जाएगा, इसलिए हम अंगुली को बाहर रखते हैं हरिनाम करते समय. क्रोध अपने हृदय में नहीं रखना चाहिए, आप लोग भी सीखेंगे. तो वो कहा, जैसे साथ ही साथ में अपने दो विद्यार्थियों को भेज दिया, जाओ परीक्षित महाराज जी को कहो कि सातवें दिन तुम्हारी जरूर मृत्यु होगी और उनको खबर दे करके चले आओ. जब वहां पर पहुंचा, वो जा रहे थे तो जाकर के सुनाया, जी हमारे गुरु जी के लड़के ने आपको अभिसंपात दिया है, सातवें दिन आपको जरूर सांप काटेगा, मरेंगे, जो कुछ करना है कर लो सात दिन के अंदर में. गौन
So Srila Gurudev is saying that just see the power that this son of a Brahmin had. He was only a 5-year-old boy, and yet he had so much power from his this brahminical power that he was able to utter a curse to kill this great king. So he said, we have no such power, but if we seriously perform our sadhana practices, then we should also... some result should be there. In any case, after the king left, he was thinking about the whole situation, and he thought, how did I become so angry at this sage? And he realized that this was a great mistake. And he thought that his family, his dynasty would be ruined because of this. And in the meantime, the small boy, he went to his father, and he got on his lap and he was crying. And then at this point the sage's meditation broke and he questioned his son, why are you crying? So the son explained the situation, that this king had offended him by putting this garland on and that he had uttered a curse that he would die within 7 days. So then his father became very disturbed at this and he said, you don't know, this is Maharaj Parikshit, he is a very great king, a great devotee. So you should not have done so. You've become angry, and for a brahmachari to become angry like this will destroy your brahmacharya. So then he called two of his students, his disciples, and he sent them to find the king and to warn him that within 7 days he would surely die from a snake bite. So they went to him and informed him of this, and they said that whatever is necessary for you to do in these final days, you should do it immediately.
Sun karke raja apna mukut aur apna rajkiya dress सब लेकर के दूर कर दिया है, और राज्यपाट स्त्री पुत्र परिवार धन संपत्ति और साथ साथ में सांसारिक अटैचमेंट सब कुछ छोड़ करके उसी समय एक क्षण की देर नहीं हुई और गंगा के किनारे आकर के बैठ गया और सोचने लगा जी मुझे क्या करना चाहिए। और इतने में होल वर्ल्ड के जितने भी बड़े बड़े विद्वान ऋषि महर्षि ब्रह्मवेत्ता सभी लोग वहां पर पहुंच गए और एक छोटा सा बालक सुखदेव गोस्वामी भी पहुंच गए। उस समय में सुखदेव गोस्वामी पागल जैसे लग रहे थे, नंगे, स्त्रियां उनके ऊपर में धूल झोंक रही थी, ताली बजा रही थी और लड़के उसके साथ में खिलवाड़ कर रहे थे। किंतु जो ही परीक्षित महाराज जी ने देखा वहां पर नारद ऋषि जी और व्यास जी और बड़े बड़े ऋषि लोग, हजारों 88,000 ऋषि लोग वहां पर थे, सभी लोग उठ करके खड़े हो गए और उनको व्यास आसन पर लेकर के बैठा दिया। उस समय परीक्षित महाराज जी ने पूछा, महाराज सुखदेव गोस्वामी आपको नमस्कार है, हमारी मृत्यु है 7 दिन में, हमें क्या करना चाहिए? केवल मेरे लिए ही नहीं, जो लोग मर रहे हैं अभी, 1 सेकंड बाकी नहीं है, अभी मरे, उन लोगों को क्या करना चाहिए, मैं क्या करूं 7 दिन के अंदर में? और जो आज न कल न परसों न बरसों, मरेंगे जरूर, इस जगत में जो जन्म लिया वो जरूर मरेंगे ही, इसलिए उनको क्या करना चाहिए? ऐसा संसार में कोई नहीं है जन्मा जो न मरे भगवान और उनके भक्तों को छोड़कर, बाकी सबको मरना पड़ेगा। और इस जगत में कितना दुख भोगना पड़ेगा इसका कोई हिसाब नहीं जो भगवान का भजन नहीं करेंगे, उनको क्या करना चाहिए? हाँ, रिपीट।
सो as soon as Maharaj Parikshit heard this news, at once he gave up his crown, his royal dress, all his worldly attachments, his family, and his royal opulence. And without a single moment's hesitation, he went to the bank of the Ganga and then inquired. He was thinking, what should I do now? And all the great sages throughout the universe, they heard what was taking place. They all congregated there. So he was inquiring from them. And at that time, Shukadeva Goswami arrived on the scene. He was wandering, naked, and also appeared to be like a madman. And he was being followed by women, village women, and children who were clapping their hands and making fun of him. And then as he came to the assembly, so many great personalities were there. Vyas was there, Narada was there, and they all stood because they recognized him. And then they invited him to sit on the Vyasasan. And at that time, Maharaj Parikshit approached him and he offered pranam to him and then inquired, what should I do? So he inquired 2 questions basically. What should I do? I'm about to die now. Within 7 days I will die. So what is my duty at this time? And he also inquired that not only me, but actually everyone in this world is dying. And they may die at any time, either today or tomorrow or after some time. So what is the duty of everyone in this world who will at some point die?
इसके बीच में और एक कथा, I am telling a very important thing. Those who are sleeping, they should be smart. Otherwise, I am giving nectar and they will sleep if they will miss. So I request them all not to sleep at all and be straight like this, very, very smart. Otherwise, you will lose that nectar. So you should be very smart and give your ears only for 5 minutes. And I will give nectar in that ears. Gaur Pramanande. Not like this. Oh, Gaur Pramanande. So, up here. Up. महाराज जी ने उनसे जब पूछा तो उन्होंने कहा जे सांप जरूर काटेगा और मरेगा, जरूर कोई नहीं बचा सकता, किंतु तुमको एक ऐसी चीज दूंगा जो तुमको कभी भी सांप स्पर्श नहीं करेगा, संसार का कोई कष्ट दुख कुछ नहीं होगा। और ये मैं सत्य पूर्वक कह रहा हूं, तुम हमारी बात में विश्वास रखो। जो मरने वाले हैं आजकल में मरने वाले हैं, वो डेथ पर बैठे हुए हैं मरने वाले, उसको संसार का करोड़ों रुपया डॉलर्स सारी एपुलेंस सारे डॉक्टर वैद्य हकीम कोई भी नहीं बचा सकता जिसको मरना है, किंतु एक चीज बचा सकता है क्या, भगवान का नाम बचा सकता है। हरेर नाम हरेर नाम हरेर नाम वही हकीम उसको बचा सकता है। इसलिए तुम भगवान का नाम अभी यदि मर रहा है तो सुनो, और जो मरने वाले हैं आज कल परसों उनके लिए क्या है, वो लोग भगवान की कृष्ण की लीला कथाओं का श्रवण करें, उनको कोई भी सर्प यहां तक जम के दूत कोई दुख क्लेश कोई भी स्पर्श नहीं कर सकेगा, ये गारंटी बात है, इस चीज को समझो। और नहीं तो जन्म से ही प्रॉब्लम मिलेंगे, दुख आएगा, कोई भी जगत में सुखी नहीं। बड़े सुंदर सुंदर स्वस्थ लड़के लाखों उनको समस्याएं, हमारे यहां भारतवर्ष में इंदिरा गांधी के दो लड़के बड़े पुष्ट बड़े विद्वान धनी अरबों खरबों रुपए, किंतु जहाज में कई एक आदमी मर गया एक्सीडेंट में और एक को किसी ने गोली मार दी, हमारे प्राइम मिनिस्टर इंदिरा गांधी को देखते देखते ही गोली मार दी, कैनेडी अमेरिका के उनको भी गोली मार दी, नेपोलियन बोनापार्ट को जीवित पकड़ करके पानी में डुबा दिया, हिटलर न जाने कहां चला गया, रशिया के कौन थे प्रेसिडेंट
स्टालिन
एंड आफ्टर दैट
लेनिन
एंड ऑल दे बिकेम मैड मुसोलिनी ऑल। इसलिए यदि जीवन में सुखी शांति रहना चाहते हैं, जन्म और मरण के चेन को पार करना चाहते हैं, बस एक दवा है। यदि आज अभी मर रहे हो बोल नहीं सकते तो अभी सुन लो कान में हरे कृष्ण, उनके कान में कह दो बचा देगा, फिर जन्म मरण में नहीं आएगा, उसके सारे दुख दूर हो जाएंगे। जैसे अजामिल का हुआ, वाल्मीकि का हुआ, लाखों उदाहरण है। और जो दो चार दिन का समय है तो क्या करो, उसको भागवत की कथा कृष्ण की लीला कथाओं सुनाओ, इतनी बलवती हैं कि इसको जन्म मृत्यु से रक्षा करके और गोलोक वृंदावन का जो नित्य सुख है उस सुख को प्रदान कर देगा।
So, when he inquired, when Pariksit Maharaj inquired from Shukadeva Goswami, he said that yes, certainly within 7 days you will die from a snake bite. But he said, now you please listen very carefully, and I will give you something that even the snake cannot touch. In other words, I will give you something by which you will not be affected by the snake bite or by anything, any type of distress in this material world. So he said, you should listen carefully. Please have faith in my words. And then Srila Gurudev was saying that in this material world, if a person is on the verge of death or has some disease, then even if one has millions of dollars and the best doctors and the best medicines, these things cannot save him. There is only one thing which can save us from these things, and that is the holy name of Bhagavan. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Eva Kevalam. So, he said, you should please hear this holy name of the Lord from me. And also, those who will die after some time, they should hear Harikatha. They should hear the narrations of the Lord's transcendental pastimes. And by doing so, they will not be approached. Yamaraj, the Lord of Death, he will not be able to approach them. He will stay far from them. And they will not be subject to the miseries of this material world. They will pass beyond these miseries. But if one does not do so, then he cannot be happy in this world. Even if he has so much opulence, so many material assets, these things cannot give happiness to the soul. So even if one is in youth and very healthy, he's still subjected to these miseries of material life. Just like he was saying, Srila Gurudev was saying, that Indira Gandhi, she had two sons, and one died in an accident, another was shot, and so many other leaders in this world. Indira Gandhi herself was shot, Kennedy was shot, and so many other leaders, Napoleon, Hitler, Mussolini, Stalin, Lenin, they all ultimately were vanquished by the miseries of material existence. So if we want to be happy in the eternal sense, if we want to cross over the chain of repeated birth and death, then there is only one medicine, and that medicine is to hear the holy name of the Lord. So by this one can stop the chain of birth and death, one can overcome the miseries of material existence, just like in the case of Valmiki. And this hearing of Bhagavad Katha, it is so powerful that not only it will put an end to the cycle of birth and death, but it will transport us to the eternal abode of the Lord in Goloka Vrindavan.
Unhone ek shlok batlaya labdhva sur durlabham idam bahu sambhavanti manushyam arthadam anittam api hadhira तुर्णम जतेत न पतेत अनुमित्तु जावत निशे शाय विशा खलु सर्वता स्या। उन्होंने ये बतलाया मनुष्य जीवन बहुत दुर्लभ है. This human life is very rare in this world. Though you are seeing so many, but it is rare. इस संसार में करोड़ों करोड़ों जीव हैं, सुअर, गधे, मच्छर, बैल, घोड़े, हाथी, पेड़, पौधे, मनुष्य खूब कम है. और मनुष्य में मनुष्य होते हुए भी चार पैर वाले ये सभी जानवर हैं, मनुष्य नहीं, जो भगवान को नहीं जानते, आत्मा को नहीं जानते. वो खाने पीने में पशुओं जैसे व्यस्त रहते हैं. इसलिए भगवान की जब दया होती है तो ये मनुष्य जन्म को देते हैं और साधुओं का संग कराते हैं. वो लोग बहुत जगत में सौभाग्यवान हैं जिनको ऐसा साधु संग मिल जाता है, अन्यथा सभी पशु के तरफ में खाते पीते और मर जाते हैं. यह मनुष्य जन्म परमार्थ को देने वाला है, परम अर्थ. इसको यों खाने पीने में पशुओं की तरह, सुअर और गधे की भांति इसको नहीं बिताना चाहिए. जो लोग केवल खाते पीते हैं, ड्रिंक करते हैं, विवाह करते हैं, भोजन ये सब करते हैं, ये तो गधे, घोड़े, सुअर भी कर लेते हैं. इसके लिए मनुष्य जन्म भगवान ने नहीं दिया, इस चीज को याद रखिए. किंतु इस मनुष्य जन्म में एक मिनट भी यदि कोई भगवान का स्मरण करे, ये गारंटी है कि जीवन में जरूर सुखी होगा. इवन वन मिनट इफ ही चांट्स वन नेम ऑफ कृष्ण with core of heart, it is guaranteed that he will be, his life will be successful and he will be happy forever. वो अपने जीवन में सुखी शांति जरूर रहेगा. श्रीमद् भागवत नहीं, वेद, पुराण, उपनिषद सबका एसेंस है ये भगवान का नाम. ऐसे मालूम होता है जी इसमें कुछ नहीं, हम तो हरे कृष्ण कर रहे हैं, किंतु इसमें बड़ी भारी शक्ति है. भगवान खींचे हुए चले आते हैं, और की तो बात क्या. इसलिए खूब विश्वास के साथ में ये हरि नाम करना चाहिए. इसलिए तुर्णम जते तना पते अनुमृत्यु जावक परीक्षित महाराज जी को मालूम था जो सातवें दिन मरेंगे उनको 6 दिन का अवकाश था, किंतु हम लोगों का कोई ठीक नहीं जो कब मर जाएंगे। नो गारंटी दैट व्हेन वी विल डाई, जस्ट टुडे, जस्ट इवन दिस टाइम, टुमारो, आफ्टर डे टुमारो, व्हेन वी विल डाई, नो गारंटी। परीक्षित महाराज हैज had guarantee for 7 days and he had 7 days harikatha, but we have no guarantee at all, hum log ko koi guarantee nahi hai, isliye turnam jatetana patet anumitya javat, kal ke liye mat rakho, aaj hi, yadi tumne kisi sadhu se suna je bhagwan ka naam karne se, bhagwan ki kathaon se hamara kalyan ho jata, to kal nahi, कल क्या होएगा, बहुरी करोगे कब, आज करो सो अब करो, कल करो सो आज कर, आज करो सो अब, पल में परलय होएगी, बहुरी करोगे कब, फिर कल नहीं आएगा, जो कल करना है उसे आज करो और जो आज करना है उसे अभी तुरंत कर लो। रावण ने सोचा था जिस स्वर्ग में जाने के लिए मैं सीढ़ी बनाऊंगा कल, किंतु एक दिन पहले ही मारा गया, नहीं कर सका, हो सकता था कि वो बना दे किसी कारण से, किंतु नहीं कर सका, इसलिए कल के लिए मत रखो, हरिनाम कल लेना है, नहीं नहीं आज ही लेंगे, आज ही लेंगे, अरे अभी ले लूंगा, अभी से, कल के लिए संकल्प मत रखो, कोई ठीक नहीं है, अभी मन ठीक है, अभी ले सकते हैं, इसलिए कल के लिए मत छोड़ो, अच्छे चीजों को कल के लिए ना छोड़ करके अभी के लिए करो। और जो लोग ये सोचते हैं आज करो सो कल कर, कल करो सो परसों, क्या सम खटखट में पड़े हुए हो, समय पड़ा है बस, समन थिंग्स दैट, हम लोग जो आज करें उसे कल करेंगे और कल करें से परसों, अरे भाई विचार करने की जाए जरूरत, अभी आज ही थोड़े मर रहे हैं, कोई ठीक गारंटी नहीं है, इसलिए आज से ही। संसार में जितने भी देवता देवी हैं, जितने भी देवता, यहाँ पर भी बहुत से देवता देवी हैं, यहाँ हनुमान जी कितने इनके मुख हैं, रामचंद्र जी के परिकर हैं, शंकर जी हैं, देवी जी दुर्गा जी हैं, ये भगवान की शक्तियाँ हैं, भगवान वही है, राम या कृष्ण हैं, एक ही तत्व है दोनों, इसलिए जितने नाम हैं उन सब नामों में पावरफुल भगवान का नाम है। ये शंकर जी हनुमान जी इतने वीर हैं किस लिए, राम का आश्रय लिए हैं, नहीं तो उनको कोई नहीं पूछता, आज राम नाम के बल में जगत में सर्वत्र इनकी पूजा होती है, इनका जन्म और मृत्यु नहीं है, अपने संग से ये भगवत भक्ति दे सकते हैं। शंकर जी का भी ऐसा है, भगवान राम 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 शंकर जी जपते हैं, इसलिए इतने पावरफुल हैं। किंतु याद रखना, रावण शंकर जी को मान करके भी मारा गया, कंस ये शंकर जी की उपासना और दुर्गा जी की करता था फिर भी मारा गया, उसका आचरण ठीक नहीं रहा, इसलिए कृष्ण और राम को ही मानो, इनकी पूजा करने से हनुमान जी शंकर जी जितने देवता देवी अपने आप प्रसन्न हो जाएंगे, इनका अनादर नहीं करना है, किंतु राधा और कृष्ण का अंतिम में भजन करना चाहिए उन्हीं का नाम, क्योंकि ये हनुमान जी राम राम करते हैं, इनके रोम रोम में राम है, ऐसा ही होना चाहिए। इसलिए कहते हैं जो कोई ठीक नहीं, कल मृत्यु होने के पहले आज ही साधु संत कोई हो उनसे अपना हरिनाम इत्यादि ग्रहण करके आज से ही हरिनाम आरंभ कर दो, कल के लिए मत रखो, परसों के लिए मत रखो। यदि कहो जैसे में बहुत खर्चा है भगवान का नाम लेने में, खर्चा है कुछ, कोई भी खर्च नहीं है, चलते फिरते उठते बैठते सोते खाते पिछलते हुए मरते हुए टट्टी करते हुए भी भगवान का नाम कर सकते हो, इतना सस्ता इतना सहज, बिना पैसे का कोई नुक्स मिलेगा और जो संसार से हमें उद्धार कर देगा, भगवान के चरण में पहुंचा देगा, सब दुखों को दूर कर देगा, ऐसा कुछ भी जगत में विश्व ब्रह्मांड में नहीं हुआ। इसलिए भगवान के प्रति विश्वास रखो, उनके नाम के प्रति विश्वास रखो, आज ही से आरंभ करना कर दो, पैसा का खर्च नहीं, कोई प्रॉब्लम इसमें नहीं है। हाँ बोलिए.
So Srila Gurudev quoted a verse from Srimad Bhagavatam, which is praising the human form of life and the rareness of this human form of life. So in this world, there are many millions of living entities, and amongst them, the number of human beings are very small. And then even amongst human beings, there are very few who come under the or come into the association of sadhus and who take up devotional life and who adopt the chanting of the Lord's holy name. Amongst human beings, those who are simply engaged in eating and sleeping and material activities, they are actually no better than the animals, because their activities are not different from the animals. We see that the animals are also engaged in these same activities. So the human life has been given by the Lord, not for this purpose. It has been given as an opportunity to realize our relationship with Him and to worship Him, particularly through the chanting of His names. So this human form of life, it is for paramartha. Artha means that which has value. Generally, in the material world, it is thought of as like economic development. But human life is not just for ordinary artha. It is for paramartha. Paramartha means the supreme value. So that is for becoming established in one's eternal relationship with the Lord. And Srila Gurudev said that if even just for one moment one sincerely chants the holy name or remembers the Lord, then their human life becomes successful. And this is the conclusion, or this is the statement, not only of Srimad Bhagavatam, but also of the Vedas, the Puranas, and all the Shastras. So the holy name of the Lord is so powerful that it can attract even the Lord Himself. It can bring the Lord Himself under control. The Lord, who is the creator of everything, who has all opulence, who is the owner of everything, the holy name can bring that supreme Lord under control. So this is the power of the holy name. So we should have faith in this. And we should take it up because there is no guarantee how long we have to live. At least Maharaj Parikshit, he knew that he had 7 days, but we may die at the next moment. So we cannot afford to gamble, not afford to waste time. Srila Gurudev was quoting a saying, two different types of sayings. One was that that which is to be done tomorrow, it should be done today. And that which is to be done today, it should be done this very moment. In other words, something that is auspicious, something that is for our welfare, we should not wait, we should not
postpone.
Yeah, we should not postpone it, we should not put it off till tomorrow. Whereas there is a tendency in this material world to say that what should be done today, I'll do that tomorrow. And then when tomorrow comes, well, I'll do that the next day. But if something is for our welfare, and especially something like this, which can vanquish all distress, which can give us the supreme welfare, that should be done immediately, without hesitation. Since our mind is now in a healthy state, in a sane state, so we should apply it immediately without hesitation to the Lord's holy name. And we can take the example of even the devatas and the devis, the celestial denizens, such as Hanuman and Durga, Shankar. They are all different potencies of the Lord, and they are also constantly engaged in chanting the glories of the Lord. Where does Hanuman get his power? He gets his power by chanting the name of Ram. And also he is able to give bhakti by this power, by the power that he gets from chanting the name of Ram. And Shankar also, he's always engaged in chanting the name of Ram. And yet we see that those certain examples of those who were devotees of Shankar or others, such as Ravan, he was a great devotee of Shankar. He worshipped him and received so much power and opulence from him. And yet he was opposed to Ram. He did not engage in chanting the name of Ram, and ultimately he was killed by him. So therefore, we should respect all of the devas and devis, but we should specifically take up the chanting of the names of Shri Radha Krishna and worship them. And in this matter, we should not hesitate. We should take it up immediately in the association of sadhus. And there's no expense in this either. It does not cost anything. And we can do it under any circumstance, while eating, while sleeping, even while
taking bath,
falling
down, also making a stool, no harm. Making urine, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. In any
circumstances,
you can chant. No loss of money, nothing to lose. So we should try to begin today, just now, from evening, this evening, not coming night, before that, we should try to begin and chant Hari Name. If you are chanting Hari Name, jadi aap Hari Naam kar rahe ho, you are chanting Hari Name, and death comes, then we can lose our whole wealth and everything, our children, our wife, we may lose. If you are chanting Hari Name, no harm. Why? If you are chanting Hari Name and not with them, again you will have, after a moment of your death, very beautiful wife. You can be a very beautiful hog. You can be pig. And your wife will be managed there very easily without marriage. Not only one, hundreds and hundreds of sheep, pigs and hogs will be there. And all kinds of very tasteful food you will have there. Very, very taja.
Delicious. Fresh.
Fresh and fresh. In India it is so available without any pies. It will be, we can have here and there in so many jungles, so many persons making a stall, and they will take it. No need of marriage. Everything will be available. So no harm if you are now in this human life, you are chanting, remembering, and hearing katha. You will have nothing to lose anything. So in this human shape, you can do this. Otherwise, in any other shape, in hogs and pigs, ox and cows, elephant, creepers, and trees, in these births you cannot take chant and cannot hear Hari Katha. One thing you should understand very strongly, that if you fell a stone in a pond, pond is so big, 1 mile broad and 1 mile length. But if you are falling that stone anywhere, the waves from there in round way, it will touch another bank. Have you seen this?
Yeah.
Similarly, if you are telling anything in this world, in this air, it will touch where? The last end of this
earth
and environment, everywhere. in whole world it will go. Not only in world, but lakhs and lakhs world it will touch that current. So if you are making, abusing anyone, you are doing nonsense, then it will also make dirty whole world and universe. But if you are chanting, it will purify in a minute everything. And that is why in world so much nonsense things are going on. Nonsense. But we see that some sadhus are chanting. As we are chanting here, he was singing, we are all singing, Hare Krishna, Jai Jai Radha Raman Hari Bol. And this current will touch whole world, whole universe, lakhs and purify. We are not knowing this. We are not aware of this, but automatically everything is going on. Krishna arranged like so. It will purify yourself, all who are here, and those who are not here anywhere in the world, in the air, they must will be purified by this. So Krishna is so merciful to make this name, holy name, so powerful. So don't forget this and felt the opportunity to take Hare Krishna, this name. From today, not today, just
now.
Just now from. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Sukadev Goswami continued and gave the example of Azamil. Azamil was very character.
Loose character.
No, very good character. And he was Brahmin. He has good father and mother, very chaste wife, some children also. He was quite young and quite learned, Vedas and everything. But one day, he saw a prostitute with any bad person. And he could not control his mind and heart. He gave up his father, mother, all good characters, his wife and children, and at once joined that bad fellow, prostitute. He sold his whole property. They become poor, their father, mother, everything. And he began to live with that bad fellow, that prostitute. He began to do murder to make money. Always drinking, doing so many sins. And he became of 84. And he has 8 children from
prostitute.
And now he forget his previous family. Father, family, and all others. And now he used to think that, oh, this is my duty because I am married with this prostitute. The children, to support, it is my duty. But he forget that duty, sacred duty of his father, mother, and children. At the age of 84, he had a son, lost son, and he kept name?
Narayan.
And when he was dying, at once, he was calling Narayan, save me, very dangerous persons are coming to take my soul. He began to do his stool and urine and he was so much afraid of that. But when he called Narayan to his son, but actually Krishna, oh, my name is Narayan, I must go there. And he came before them and told that the members of Jamdod, messengers, oh, don't come. You cannot come because he has chanted my name. He has prayed my name. And they beat him and the Jamdutas and they fled away and they went to Jam Maharaj and they told that, who are they? we think thought that you are Narayan, more than Narayan, you are master of whole world, you are controlling whole world, but who are they? Oh, don't go there. If anyone at the time of dying, he may be so wretched person, sinful person, characterless person, slaughtered so many persons. But yet if he is uttering Hare Krishna or any name of God, Ram, or anything, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, don't go so many miles nearer to him. Yeah. Okay? You should be very far away from them. If anyone has taken
neck beads, those
neck beads, don't go there. They are in Krishna control. He can punish them or he can
release them.
Do anything, release them. It depends on. I am not monarch of all. Lakhs and lakhs jam are under him. Lakhs and lakhs, koti koti. So if anyone chanting Hari name, it is so powerful. Krishna himself comes in the shape of name and he saves all. And if he is taking chanting with honor, having this mantra from Gurudev, then not only he will be saved from death, but he will be saved after everything, and he will go to Braja and he will test all the anand by serving Krishna and Radha, conjugal, or Ram. And he showed this example. After this, he told the story of Prahlad Maharaj. When we will be old, then we will chant name. It is absurd. It cannot be. Then you cannot see it like this. Then you will see it like this. No? You cannot chant at that time. So you should chant this name from beginning of your life at the age of 5, if you have at that time knowledge this. Little knowledge. No need of knowledge. No need of anything, energy. No need of money, nothing. Nothing. Only chant Hare Krishna. So Prahlad Maharaj was telling to his all fellows who were learning there.
Class fellows.
And Shanda Marka was teaching them that drink, eat, drink and be merry. This is the real life. You should be always very happy. But in this life, making merry and this, anyone is not happy. Anyone, even the Queen of Holland, the Queen of Elizabeth, or what name, I don't know, of England, even the President of America, anyone is not. There are so many cases against him in court. Always so much, like pendulum, he is. So this path is not okay. So try to, from beginning of your life, when you are 5, 3, 1 year, take that boy to any sadhu and tell that, you should utter Krishna name in his ear. This is sanskar. So we should do sanskar from very beginning. Otherwise, if everything will be written on the any paper, then you cannot write again on that paper. Understand?
Yes.
Because it will be black by writing. What writing? All worldly things, all worldly desires. So our heart is like a paper. When we will be of 25, 28, 40, then we will have some idea, and that idea cannot be changed, never will be changed. But in Vahivut, our heart is soft, it is clear, no dirty. At that time, what you will teach that boy, it may take it. But you should also consider that past impression, some works. If he has no past impressions, then he will not take it very easily. Aisha ruchi pariksha of a boy of 1 or 2, you know, 6 months or age of, or about 1 year. A boy which shaved his head and given Mahaprasadam to his mouth, and then we were testing his
inclination. Inclination.
Inclination, where is this? We put laddu, misty means
sweet,
sweet, knife, golden
ornaments,
golden, silver,
pen, Gita, Ramayana, and so many things. Some toys also. He came just and he took knife. This is like not good so much. If there was pistol, perhaps he may take it, because the first impression is like so. And if anyone takes with boy, little boy, according to his own wish, he may take Gita, oh, he will be religious. At first, it was in our Vedic culture, it is done. And we see that it is true to extent. But if any boy takes knife, and we will give him, oh, you should take Harinam, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, repeatedly, then it will be changed. His impression will be changed by name. So from the beginning, from today, we should try to chant Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
If you can chant whole name and death is coming, only Hare, Hare will do. Not Hare or Krishna, Krishna, so on. Only. So, our time is now over, because we will have to go some far away, and devotees also. So I'm finishing my classes here, and I wish that all should take Harinam, because there is no need of money, no need of energy, whether you are old or new, whether you are householder or renowned, whether you are learned or not learned, whether you are doing any job, no harm. You should try to begin chant from today. Don't lose your time. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
One kirtan. Shri Krishna.
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
धैर्य हमको आप लोग समय दे रहे हैं ठीक
यही
Who's got the key? Okay.
Yes, great.
You have also come? You have key?
We got everyone too.
Who has key?
No, bring nothing about
that. Now it's about me to bring something.
Don't
give him cool.
So much cold. Not too cold, yes. Keep him warm, yeah.
You're happy?
Nice.
You're happy.
Do you come again?
Please visit your bath.
Now it's over. I have the things here for the meeting, but I have to explain to you something. I can wait.
कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरत्विषे नमः गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो नमः। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम ऑफरिंग माय लैक्स एंड लैक्स दंडवत प्रणाम इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ माय गुरुदेव नित्य लीला प्रविष्टम विष्णुपाद श्रीमद्भक्ति प्रज्ञान केशव गोस्वामी महाराज। आई ऑल्सो ऑफर माई हम्बुल दंडवट्स इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ माई शिक्षा गुरु श्री श्रील भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी महाराज एंड और ऑल आचार्यस ऑफ डिसिप्लिक ऑर्डर। आई विल टेल समथिंग and we should try to accept if it is true, and if it is not true you can reject, no harm. I'm telling first some Vedic culture, especially to follow for devotees, it is essential. We are part and parcel of Supreme Personality of Godhead. All the element, animals, human beings, males, females, tigers, trees, creepers, all are so, and they are all part and parcel of Supreme Personality of Godhead. But anyhow, now we are all forgetting Supreme Personality of Godhead. And we have come to this world. We cannot say definitely to anyone that God is true. But we can tell it very boldly that those who have taken birth, they will have to die, certainly. To die is true. And next, also something is true, that in this life, there are so many problems, suffering, sorrows, beautiful face, after some days they become old. All beauty goes away. He cannot walk. And after that, we will have to give up this body also. And what you have gained in this world, collected with so labor, whole life, you cannot take anything, even your ears, hairs, nothing you can take from. So why you are doing so all these things if you cannot take anything? And you must, one day you will be old, all sex will go down, teeth go away, everything, beauty will go away. You cannot walk at that time. This reality we should try to realize. Anyhow, we have come to this world. But if you are wise enough, intelligent, then you should think that from where we came, and where to go one day? After 100 years, but you will have to go, but where to go? And what is the reason that there are coming so much problems? So much problems. We all do for welfare, to be happy. But in this world, we see that a very rich person, even the president of Russia and
America,
the queens of Holland, England, Belgium, and all other things, in India also the president, prime minister, none are happy. So many problems. Why it comes? And how we can remove this? Can we remove or not? If you are not thinking these things, then we are all animal. So wise person, intelligent person should think this thing. I'm coming to Indian culture, something that there was a pair, husband and wife. They were very restricted families. They were married. But anyhow, the beautiful person, husband, became he was attacked with leprosy. You know leprosy? He was so much. He could not earn anything. Always sick. Always some bad smell coming from his body. So all were hating him. But his wife was not so. He was chaste lady. Sometimes the husband, though he was feeling leprosy, but yet he was so lusty and so many bad habits, drinking also. But his wife was so lusty, so
chaste.
She always prays to Krishna that my husband should be good and he should be changed. Or reform. One day the husband was so unhappy. Very feeling so unhappy. Wife came and told that, oh, why you are unhappy? He became so furious and angry and he wanted to beat her wife. But her wife was so humble. Why? You should tell me why you are so unhappy. He told at last that, you know that I am lusty. I have seen today a very beautiful lady. And I want to meet her anyhow. But I know that she cannot meet me because I'm a leprosy person. And she is very high restricted family lady. She cannot meet me. Then she told, I said, yes, I'm making arrangements that you can meet. She went to that lady. For several days he served her. And that lady became so happy and satisfied. Then he told her, why you are serving me? I want to give you something what you want. She told that, I want that my husband wants to meet you. So please be kind enough to meet with my husband. Or you can bring. So in the night, she took her leprosy husband on his back and chanting, remembering Hare Krishna, and she was taking his husband to that lady. In the way, a rishi was, rishi you know?
Saintly person.
Saintly person was lying, he was chanting and remembering and meditating. This lady was carrying his husband And the feet was, the legs of the husbands was
touching.
Hanging.
Hanging. So it was touched by the head of that
saint.
At once his meditation was
broken.
Broken. And he told that who has touched me, he will die surely when sun will rise this morning. But lady was very unhappy that I will lose my husband and he will die in the morning. So he told that if I am chaste lady, then sun should not come in morning. And thus my husband will be survived. All were waiting for morning, but morning was not coming, sun was not coming. So all were so worried, all were began to die, then all went to Brahma, why sun is not coming? So many hours, days, and so many months away, but sun is not coming. Then Brahma, they all, devatas, goddess, went to Brahma. Then Brahma saw that, oh, this chaste lady has stopped sun by his chasteness. He went there and told that, why you are stopping sun to come? She told that if morning will come, my son, my husband will die. Then Brahma told that if he will die, at once I will make him very new and very beautiful human body and ever young and so much qualified I will make him. So let son come. Then chaste lady told that I know that you are Brahma, but you will have to give word what you have told, and you will have to promise that if sun will come and my husband will die, then he will come in a renewed form, very young and very beautiful. And he will be changed, and he will be also chaste husband. Then Brahma promised, and sun came, and at once he died, and at once he became so beautiful again, young. And then he told that I've done mistake, wrong, that leaving you, I wanted to go to prostitutes and so much lusty, but now I have realized that I have done wrong. So I promise for whole life that I will not be like so. I'm giving up all my bad habits, drinking and everything. And then she returned. He never went to that lady, and from there he returned. So this is Vedic culture. Once married to anyone, it is better not to marry, to be bachelor. For male or female, both. But if married, anyhow, Krishna has told to gopis, if husband is blind, if he is lame, he cannot earn anything, he is idle, he is ill, even chaste ladies should not give up their husband. And in other hand, we see Ramchandra left anyhow to please common person, general person, and he left Sita. But he did not left Sita from his heart. He made a
golden statue.
A statue of Sita. And worshipping there, how worshipping? Like Sita was in forest. Nothing to eat, very hardly to read, in the shades of trees, in rain, in hot sun, always reminding Ram, 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 Ram. And here Ram, in the very big palace, alone in a room, not in bed. On the ground he used to sleep, no sleep, always Sita, 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 Sita. Always weeping for Sita. Sita has two sons, Lava and Kush, and his guru, Valmiki Maharaj, who always used to give consolation to Sita. But there was none to give consolation to Ram. So Ram was more happy, more unhappy. And he was telling that how Sita will come to me. But at last they meet. So these are Indian cultures. We should try to follow all these things. Husband, chest husband, and wife also like that. If anyone, now in Western countries, it is very big problem, very, very big, for nothing. And they give divorce to each other. I will request them not to do so. If you want to do bhajan, if husband does some mistake, wife should try to reform him. And if he is reformed and he gives words and he becomes humble and give all these things, then she should again with him. And husband should also think that she is not my puppet, that I will
make her dance
here and there. She is not a puppet. She is half of the life. And thus we can do bhajan, otherwise not. We should not be lusty. We should try to give up all kinds of
bad habits.
So I think that, and request that you should not, for a little things, you should divorce each other. And if you have done, if husband had done some mistake, and if wife gives up, then he does blunder mistake. And if the lady, wife, does something and he left, then he does blunder. They cannot do bhajan. But if anyone giving up Harinam, Hari bhajan, then it should be considered. Wife should not be with husband and husband should give up that lady. We have come in this world to do bhajan. So we should try to be like that. Next thing, there was a father. He was so young. And he has benediction that he will never be old. He will not die. He will not die in sky, or he will not never be die in earth, never die in water, by weapon, anyway, not in morning, not in evening, not in day, not in night, he will not die. He had taken a benediction from creator of this world. And he became so powerful that he began to do so many things incorrect here and there. But he has four sons, and that last son was named
Prahlad.
And the father was known as Hiranyakashipu. The name of Hiranyakashipu is really very fit for him. Hiranya means gold. And Kashipu means weight. Those who always want to marry, eat, drink and marry. And by money, we can be happy. Gold is money. So if anyone thinks that I will be happy by gold, by making merry, taking fresh eggs and drinking so much wine, alcohol, that alcohol, that he will
lie on the
street. Not a street,
gutter.
On the
drain,
and dogs washing their mouths by their waters.
Salty water.
And if he's thinking that I am monarch of all. So, Hiranyakashipu is like that. In ancient time, in Vedic period, he was alone Hiranyakashipu. But now, we cannot count. Oh, so many, everywhere Hiranyakashipu. So, from boyhood, Prahlad Maharaj and his father were struggling. Boy was not struggling, he was very humble. He has so many qualities. He never protested his father, but his father was so angry.